For more context on what this means for the Senate and for the future of Senator Meredith, let's go to Michael Gagan. He's a political consultant, follows Canadian politics, and he's standing by today in Victoria in British Columbia. Are you surprised by this recommendation for full expulsion, Michael?
I'm actually a little bit surprised, pleasantly surprised. I was thinking, you know, any organization tends to protect their own. So, overall, I was pleasantly surprised to see the Senate committee make such a decisive recommendation. And I think it bodes well in terms of, you know, the future of the Senate as an institution.
You think about the Senate really being under the microscope over the past couple of years because of, you know, Mike Duffy and Pamela Wallin and Patrick Brazeau. And so I wonder what you think the message is that the Senate is trying to send out there to Canadians. It's obviously the message to Senator Meredith himself, but, you know, bigger picture.
Absolutely. You know, the Senate knows that Canadians have serious misgivings. I mean, notwithstanding our constitutional logjam, the fact that it is not an elected body. And so right away they have a credibility gap, and so every scandal further undermines the confidence that Canadians have in that institution. So for them to take decisive action, I think that will help restore some modicum of confidence that Canadians can have in terms of the standards the Senate is going to hold themselves to.
I'm also curious whether you think at this point now, knowing what is coming, and of course, the senator does not know which way the Senate will vote, but certainly there's been a lot of pressure, and a lot of the senators who've spoken to the media have said he needs to do the right thing and resign. Do you think he might choose to resign?
Well, you know, so far he has not shown any indication. He's admitted to making a mistake. He's apologized for it, but he has shown absolutely no inclination in terms of resigning. You know, let's face it, I don't think there's many Canadians who wouldn't welcome, you know, a Senate appointment, given the pay versus the mandated duty. So, you know, he's been a little, dare I say it, shameless in terms of not wanting to resign.
He hasn't broken any laws, though, Michael, and so I wonder whether there is, you know, a defense that can be made for the senator saying that, in fact, he should be allowed to stay.
You know, it's one of those things, you know, I'm a 51-year-old, I have a 16-year-old daughter. It just doesn't pass the smell test, this kind of conduct. He's a Pentecostal minister as well as a senator. He's in a, you know, a position of great influence. And for him to, you know, use that position in order to, you know, for, you know, sexual reasons, that's just beyond the pale, regardless of whether or not it's legal. He abused his power.
Right. And was appointed by Stephen Harper, a conservative senator at the time as well, when he received his appointment, and was often an advocate for so-called family values and a social conservative as well. So there is also that element being involved in this sort of relationship, which many find inappropriate, given his conservative background, whether there's a certain amount of hypocrisy on that front as well.
Absolutely. It was hugely hypocritical. And yeah, he was not shy about saying one thing at the pulpit and doing very much the opposite in private.
Is it possible that the Senate could choose, you know, not quite the full extreme nuclear option here? And maybe they decide to suspend him for a little while. And if that's the case, because it seems to me that they're not sort of unified here, Michael, in terms of the options. Some senators are worried about getting rid of him because of the precedent that could set. It's never been done before in Canadian history.
Well, you know, it's one of those things where I think the Senate, if they undertook some half or quarter measure rather than full expulsion, I don't think it bodes well in terms of the future of the Senate. It also won't reflect well on the Conservatives because, as you pointed out, this is, you know, another scandal from another Conservative-appointed senator. And for the Conservative Party then to close ranks, let's say, to try and keep this person there just simply as, you know, a reliable vote in the upper chamber. Again, it's going to completely undermine their moral arguments that they'll want to be making going into the next federal election. So I think there's a lot for, you know, senators and particularly conservative senators to think about in terms of whether to accept or reject or amend the recommendation of this Senate committee.
Political analyst Michael Gagan joining us from Victoria on Vancouver Island. Great to have you, Michael, as always. Thanks for your expertise on this.
Thank you, sir.